just stepping through this diagram, okay, we start off with some underlying distribution, pardon my inability to trace, okay, but of course we don't actually have a real distribution. What we have is a set of particles, okay? Those particles are not uniformly weighted. Remember, the sum of all the weights is one. Some particles have more weight than others. That is, that particle has a higher probability, all right? So here's what we do. The first thing we do is we draw a set of samples from this set. Okay, now you'll notice here in this nice picture, one of my big particles happened to get sampled three times. The medium particles got sampled twice, and this one got sampled once. And by the way, notice, how many times did these itty-bitty particles get sampled? Not at all. That's okay, because you're doing a random sample because it corresponds to the density. And that random sampling sometimes gets all the particles, sometimes only gets the ones with significant weights. So we do the sampling. Now the next thing you'll see is that each one of these particles has been shifted, but you'll notice that the shifts are not always the same. So why do you think that is? Do you know why that is? There's a deterministic part. Nothing says that my deterministic part has to be the same for all my guesses of the previous state. Okay? Let's suppose what I do is I take a step proportional to the number of lines that are on the floor, right? So I'm going to step three lines. But if the lines are closer here than they were over here, relax, Megan, then going three lines over here would actually mean I'd moved a smaller amount than if I was over here. If I'd gone three lines, I would have gone a further amount. All this means is that the deterministic part doesn't have to be the same everywhere. It's just deterministic. Then we add in essentially what could be thought of as the diffusion part or the uncertainty part. Remember when we were generating the new sample, we did the deterministic part plus the probabilistic part. And that's what's here, right? So after we take a sample and we move it, we add some noise, and we do that every time we had drawn a sample. So since we drew three samples from this particle, it ended up at three different places. Likewise for all the others. Then what we do is we take our measurement, and we've got P of Z given X. That's what this value is. And we just multiply these weights, which are all one to start with, by that value. Okay, oh, here it is, P of Z given X. We just multiply it and we end up with this new set of particles, okay? So if I erase my figures there, you take a look, that's a beautiful figure. It's all of particle filtering. Just sleep with it under your pillow and you'll be in great shape.